Hello, hello, and good morning, good afternoon, good evening, depending on what time you're watching this video. And welcome back to another session of Vocabulary 101. In this session, we look at words related to numbers 3 up to 10. Pretty much the way we did with the previous session, session 4, where we looked at the number 1, the roots mono, solo, uni, and proto. Similarly, in this time, we look at the roots for number 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, etc. Okay? So buckle your seatbelts, this is going to be fun. So let's start with the number 2. The roots or the prefixes for the number 2 are buy, die, and do, right? So the first word is binary. Binary means related of or consisting of two things. Bi is two. Binary is anything that has any phenomena or concept which has two things involved. You can use the word binary there. For example, it's a very, very common word in the computer age. The language of the computer is the binary language, right? Why? Because the computer only understands two digits or two possible states of 0 and 1. So that is called the binary language of computers. Yeah. There could also be a binary star system. Looking at the image would help, or maybe a Google search would help in understanding what a binary star system is. Or a binary star or a planetary system is essentially where two stars or two planets revolve around each other, or they're locked with each other, right? Their movement are affected by each other. So such a system is known as a binary system. So now anywhere where you see a system made up of two things, you can use the word binary according to your own convenience, right? Next up is binoculars. In the previous session, we looked at the word monocle. Mono was one and ocle was eye. So the same root for eyes is here. Ocular is the root, or oculus is the root for eye. Bi means two. So binocular is anything that uses two eyes. So all human beings are binoculars, because there could also be animals with one eye. Now, but in common language, binoculars refers to an optical instrument with a lens for each eye, used for viewing distant objects. Yeah, so basically if you look through it, an object which is far away appears nearer to you, right? I'm sure most people in their lives have seen a pair of binoculars somewhere or the other. Next up is biped. Bi means two and ped means foot. So biped is any animal that uses two legs for walking. So humans are biped, okay? A quadruped would be any animal that uses four legs for walking, right? A cow or a dog or most animals. A centipede, for example, centi is 100. We look at this root later maybe. And ped means foot. So a centipede is an animal or an insect which has 100 legs, right? Bicameral. Now, we know bi is two and cameral is chambers. So a bicameral is typically a legislative body made up of two houses. Like our political system, there is a Lok Sabha and an upper house known as the Rajya Sabha. So there are two houses in the overall parliamentary system. So such a system can be called a bicameral system. Bifurcate. Now, bifurcate is to divide into two or fork into two. Bi means two, and furca is the root, is the same root as the fork. So when a path divides into two, such a situation would be called a bifurcation. Bigamy. We know bi is two and gamos is marriage. So bigamy is the offense of two marriages. Now it's an offense in certain cultures. In some other cultures it might be allowed depending on what the political and cultural situation is. But in the dictionary, the word means the offense of two marriages, right? So the offense part is included in the meaning of the word. Using gamos or gamy, we can also look at the word polygamy. Poly means many and gamos is marriage. So polygamy is many marriages. So when one person can marry a lot of people, or let's say more than two or three people, that situation is known as polygamy. Now, it might not be prevalent in where you live or the culture around you, but there are parts of the world where the system of marriage is polygamous. So one person would have many wives, or one woman would have many husbands. The word for the situation where one woman has many husbands is polyandry. Poly means many, and andros is the root for men. So many men. So if one woman has many husbands, such a situation or such a cultural situation will be known as polyandry, right? Next up is another prefix for the number two, which is die, or the other form of it, which is do. right? Dai and du are Greek prefixes, just the way bi was a Latin prefix for the number two. The first word is dichotomy. Dai means two, and tomy is to cut, or especially cut surgically. So this tomy combined with another word, any other prefix, would carry the form of cutting. Now dai is two, and tomy is to cut, so dichotomy is to cut into two, right? Or essentially a division or contrast between two things that are or are represented as being opposed or entirely different. So there is a clear-cut contrast, stark division, opposition or difference involved between two things. So such a situation, the word uses dichotomy, right? The dichotomy between science and religion, right? The dichotomy between good and bad. The dichotomy between rural and urban India, or rural and urban situations anywhere almost. Next up is diploma. A diploma is a certificate awarded by an educational institute to show that someone has successfully completed a course of study. Now, dai is two, and diploma means a folded paper, or the folded being the sense of doubling. When you fold a paper, you double it, right? So this comes from 300, 400 years back, when these universities and educational establishments were just coming up and forming. So a certificate would be provided on a piece of paper, and this piece of paper would be folded over so that it could be carried from one place to another, or from one city to another, right? Or put into an envelope, right? So that sense got carried over into the idea of certificate. So a diploma is a folded piece of paper, or essentially a certificate. Yeah. Next up is diverge. Die is two, and verge is to turn. So when something turns into two, so let's say there is a path or a line which splits into two and starts going into different directions. So that situation is known as a divergence, or the verb is to diverge. When one thing splits into two, that is to diverge. Separate from another route and go in a different direction, right? For example, the flight path diverged from the original flight plan, or you are diverging from the discussion. You are going away from the discussion. I think there was a movie also recently called Divergence, where one person did not fit into that already given path, right? So die is two, and verger is to turn or incline. So when a path splits into two or goes in two directions, that is called a divergence, right? It's a verb. Next up is dilemma. Dilemma is a situation in which a difficult choice has to be made between two or more alternatives, especially ones that are equally undesirable, right? Or you don't like both these situations, right? A difficult situation or a problem, essentially. So die is two, and lemma is a premise, or premise is a reason, essentially. So having two reasons, so being confused between two options, or having a difficult time in choosing between two options is a dilemma. Should you marry Rita or should you marry Sita? So that's a dilemma, right? Should you play cricket and make a career in sports, or should you play it safe and go for your MBA? So this kind of a situation will be a dilemma. The really interesting part is that even the Hindi prefix for the number two is du. Right. So, and the very similar word to dilemma is duvidha. So du is two, and vidha, I'm guessing, is either path or reason or something like that. But the connection is very, very clear, that how all of these languages are very, very connected to each. So another form of the prefix dai is du, very much like the Hindi prefix du. It means two. So the first word is dual. Dual is anything which is consisting of two parts, elements or aspects, very much like the binary. The dual role at work, dual personalities, dual functions, anywhere where there are two things involved, you can use the word dual, right? The word duplicate is to make a copy, essentially exact copy. But when you make an exact copy of something, aren't you doubling their number? So when you're doubling something by making a copy, that is duplicating. Or very, very simply, duplicating is making an exact copy of something, right? Next is duel, a very interesting word. A prearranged contest with deadly weapons between two people in order to settle a point of honor. So when two people fight each other out, that is known as a duel. That's the whole meaning. But in common and popular language, whenever two people are fighting with each other and there is some drama involved, we can probably call it a duel, right? The word, the origin of the word du is two, and it's a combination of the word prefix du and the root bellum, which is war. The root bellum as war is there in words like rebellion, antebellum, rebellious, bellicose, belligerent, etc. So bellum was a god of war or just war. So it was duellum or dubellum, two people warring with each other, and slowly the word just reduced to duel, right? So duel is a prearranged contest with deadly weapons between two people. That's the whole meaning. But maybe whenever two people, even when they're fighting verbally, maybe the word can be used in such situations, right? Or in a sports contest also. So deadly weapons or death is not really necessary, but that's the origin of the word, right? Next up is duet. It's a common enough word in the now. By now, guessing also should be pretty easy. Du is two. So a duet is a performance by two singers, instrumentalists, or dancers. So any kind of performance where there are two people involved is a duet, right? So when there's a man and a woman singing together, that is called a duet. Or when there are two people dancing together, that can also be called a duet. Though in common language, people typically refer to duet only to music or singing. But that's really not true. Anywhere where there are two performers or singers involved, that situation can be called a duet, right? Very similar to the word duet is the word duo. Duo is a pair of people or things, especially in music or entertainment. For example, the duo of Laurel and Hardy, the dynamic duo Batman and Robin, or let's say two bowlers in a team or two batsmen who have a good partnership going can also be considered a duo, right? So duo is two. Duo is a pair of people or things, especially in music or entertainment. Okay, so that pretty much covers it for the number two, the roots, the prefixes being by, thy, and du. This is not a comprehensive list. You will see a lot of other words with by, thy, and du. But now you know the prefix means to. So whenever you see such a word, guessing the meaning of the word would be slightly easier, right? Moving on to the number three. The prefix for three, very much like in Sanskrit or Hindi, is tri, right? Even in Hindi, it's three. Trivedi, Trikon, Trimurti, Trishul. All of these words have an aspect of the number three, and the prefix in Hindi is three. It's very, very similar to the English prefix, which is tri, right? So the first word is trident. A trident is a three-pronged spear. Yeah, or a trishul. The image would be easier to understand than the definition. Next up is a very interesting word, triad. Triad is very simply put a group or set of three related people or things. So three musical notes, three celebrities, three brothers. Anywhere there is a set of three, you can use the word triad, right? But triad is also, more interestingly, a secret society originating in China involved in organized crime, or basically the mafia of the East, or China and Japan, right? Now, why triad? Because these are triple union societies, the union of heaven, earth, and man. Now, what does heaven and earth and man mean in the Chinese context or in the Eastern philosophy context? That you have to find for yourself. But these societies were involved in organized crime. Now, they are just called triads or triad gangs, right? Basically, underworld criminal organizations. Yeah, triple union society or triads. Okay, triptych. This is not a very common word. This means a picture or relief carving on three panels. Yeah, a picture on three panels, typically joined together vertically and used as a showpiece or as an altarpiece. Yeah? Or it is a set of three associated artistic, literary, or musical works intended to be appreciated together. So let's say another word for it would be trilogy in movies and books. Right. So if somebody writes three books which are supposed to be connected together or are related together, that could be considered a triptych. So in art, literature, or in music, if there is a three-piece work, that can be considered a triptych, or basically a picture or painting in three parts, typically standing vertically and connected together. Another point that I want to repeat here is that a lot of time images are more useful than the definition. So in this case also, the image of the triptych would be easier to understand and grasp rather than just the dictionary definition. So when you're working on your vocabulary, especially these days in the modern age of internet and computers and having a lot of access to a lot of kind of resources, I would definitely use images to enhance my vocabulary, to grasp the meaning faster and quicker. So whenever you are trying to learn a new word, you should minimum do a Google search and do an image search, see what you can come up with. Yeah, the definition is good, but image can be better, right? Okay, next up, and another very interesting word is triumvirate. Okay, originally it refers to a group of three men holding power. Specifically, it refers to Julius Caesar, Pompey, and Crassus in 60 BC. These are characters from the Roman Empire, very famous people even now. So this was the first coalition of these three people, and it was called the Triumvirate. Nowadays, a group of three powerful or notable people or things, any group of three powerful or notable people is known as a triumvirate. For example, the triumvirate of Tendulkar, Ganguly, and Dravid, or the triumvirate of let's say Brahma, Vishnu, and Mahesh. So anywhere where there are three notable, powerful things or people involved, that can be considered a triumvirate, right? You should do a Google search for this. Julius Caesar, Pompey, and Crassus was the first triumvirate. What is the, or who were involved in the second triumvirate? Yeah, that's a question for you to figure out. Next is an easy enough word. It's trilogy. Tree is three, logos is words or language. So it's a group of three related novels, plays, or films, like the Lord of the Rings trilogy, the Spider-Man trilogy. I don't know whether three or not, but anywhere there are three books or three movies or three plays in a series, that is a trilogy. Next is trivial. The word trivial means something that is of little value or importance, something which is not very, very important. So trivial details, trivial matters, trivial conversations where you're just talking about little details, how's the weather, how you feeling. You're not talking about very high concepts, right? So trivial is of something that is of little value or importance, or a person who is concerned only with petty things, who's concerned only with small things. So the word is fairly easy. Trivial means of little value or importance. But what's the connection with three here? The word trivial comes from the Latin word trivium, and trivium means a place where three roads meet, or essentially a junction or a common junction where roads are coming together. Yeah. Now let's say when you're standing at such a place, right, would you be talking about very important matters, like would you be sharing secrets with someone or sharing your deepest anxieties or your greatest hopes with someone in such a place, or would you be talking about minor details of life, about how's the weather and how generally chit-chatting about things which are not very, very important? Why? Because that is not the kind of place where you would want to talk about very, very personal things, because there are a lot of people around, there's a lot of movement around, probably you're not very safe and comfortable in such a place, right? So from the place trivium where three roads meet, the kind of conversation you would have at such a place are called trivial, or trivial details, trivial matters, right? I hope you get the connection. Yeah. Okay, moving on. The next number is the number 4, and the root for it is qua or quad, right? Quad means 4. These days...